The 67-year-old replaces Serbian coach Mićo Radojević, who was sacked following a disappointing 2023 African Cup of Nations qualification campaign. Paul Port boasts with some huge coaching experience on the African continent, having guided Burkina Faso to the 2013 Africa Cup of Nations final, and has been tasked to create a fresh new direction for Uganda national football.
To bring a team, a strong team, a team who can perform for 2027. That will be one of my first challenges. The second challenge is to install a universal playing style for Uganda national teams, produce an entertaining and purposeful football. Also, if we see what's going on with the players, we see a little bit in Europe, we don't find Ugandan players. Therefore, we're going to put something also in place that we can handle it, that we have also Uganda players who are playing or going to play for European teams, and that he can make the name. It will be a good publicity for Uganda football. It will be a good publicity for the players, for everyone. And this is also one of my challenges. Then also, of course, the qualification for CHAN. We have the qualification for AFCON 25, all in perspective for 2027, and of course the qualification for World Cup 2026.
His first significant challenge will be the upcoming World Cup qualifiers against Guinea and Somalia in Bakane, Morocco on November 17th and 21st respectively.
In my speech, if you don't believe that we can qualify, it's better to stay in Uganda. So therefore, I came to Uganda also to prove something, and I'm sure it will take long, and at the end, you can qualify it. So the heart is always, in the beginning is always hard, but at the final, I'm sure you can have a good opportunity to qualify the team.
For President Moses Magogo and Port are optimistic about Uganda Cranes' chances of qualifying for the 2026 World Cup from Group G, which includes Algeria, Guinea, Mozambique, Botswana, Somalia, and Uganda.
We are a federation that enter competitions with a purpose. We enter all competitions with a purpose. Our purpose of entering the 2026 FIFA World Cup is to qualify. And it remains our intention that we are going to compete and not to participate.
Port, whose career has been tarnished by scandal, including alleged match-fixing, was among the 245, including two local coaches, who applied for the job. In 2008, Port was given a three-year ban by Belgium's Football Federation for alleged involvement in a match-fixing scandal, although he has said he was a scapegoat. Guinea also banned him from all football activity for life in 2019 when he was in charge of their national team. Regarding past match-fixing scandals, the journalists questioned Port, but Magogo defending him, urging the focus to be on the present.
Question asked the coach, let us be Ugandan. We know that the coach we have hired is not under any sanctions. Is a coach who is eligible to operate, is licensed, and let us concentrate on that. If you think you have information, go and dig it out and write it. It's your right. We are not going to control what you write, and that's your business. So the coach will not answer that question. Thank you.
Paul Port is expected to announce the Ghana Cranes squad for the upcoming World Cup qualifiers against Guinea and Somalia in due course this week. Uganda Cranes will play both games away in Bakane City of Morocco November 17th and 21st, respectively.
Up.